Today I want to go ahead and show you some tips and tricks on how I went and retouched this photograph of the winter moon. I actually took this photograph a couple winters back, and the full moon was actually just starting to break out of the clouds right here. I went ahead and set up my tripod with my camera, and I had a wide angle lens on there with no filters. And then I hooked up my remote so there was no chance of a camera shake on this one. So then just to show you real quick on my settings, after a couple practice runs, I finally settled down on 8 seconds at aperture 11 and ISO 800. And I was using my Tokitna 11x16mm f2.8 lens, which works really good for these types of photographs. Now, right about the time I was taking this photograph, a jetliner actually flew through across here, which left a contrail. And what was so cool about it, it just happened to line up right with the moon here, which gave it a really cool looking effect to it. Also, one advantage of going with aperture 11 or a little higher, it starts to create a cool looking star effect with the moon here. So that was another reason I chose a little higher aperture instead of the 7.1 or a little bit lower. So I want to show you real quick the before and after shot here. So here's the before shot. As you can see, it looks a little bit darker, not quite as appealing, but I did shoot this in raw format, and I knew I was shooting this in raw. So one big advantage of shooting in raw format is to be able to bring out the information and really make your photographs pop. So if you start to get into these types of photographs, I strongly recommend shooting in raw. Okay, let's go ahead and do a retouch on this photograph. I'll take you from start to finish. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit reset. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is bring up the exposure just a little bit here. So I'm gonna kind of crank this up to about 1.00 on that one. I just really had to bring up the light on this. Now, the first thing I do notice is I do have some lens flare I want to fix on this one. So let me zoom into one of the spots here. Here's one location. So I'm going to go to the spot removal tool right here. Click once. I'm going to hover over where I need to fix the spot, and I'm just scrolling the wheel on my mouse just to kind of get right over the top of it. Now, you do have an option over here for feathering if you want to lower the feathering or increase it. But this one, I want to keep the feathering about 100, which kind of helps match the clouds pretty good. I'll hit done on that. Okay, the next thing I want to do is I'm going to come over here to the highlights, and let's go ahead and bring the highlights down a little bit. And it kind of brings the lights down a little more here and bring the moon. And let's take the shadows up a little brighter. Now I'm going to do is hold the option key down on my Mac, which is your alt key on PC. And I'm going to hold it down, and on the whites, I'm going to click and take the whites to the right. And I'm actually going to blow the moon out just a little bit and some of the other lights just to make them pop a little bit. And then I'm going to once again hold down my option key, and I'm going to click on the blacks, and I'm going to pull that to the left, go a little bit on the negative side. I want to come up here to the graduated filter, click once. I'm going to click and drag up. So I'm trying to get everything below this filter. Now I want to do is come under the highlights, and I'm going to take the highlights down even more. And what's cool about this is I'm only affecting these lights, and I'm not affecting the moon right here. And then I'm going to bump the exposure back up just a little bit, and then I'll take the whites just up just a notch right here too. Then I'm going to hit done. Okay, right under here under presence, I'm going to go to clarity. Let's just bump this clarity up to about 12. We'll take the vibrance and saturation both to about 12. Now you're going to notice it's really yellow looking, so I'm going to fix that down here. So under the HSL color and black and white tab here, if you just click on that, go under saturation, I want to bring down the yellows. So I just don't want this thing looking so much yellow in it. So let's just take that to about negative 52. And then I'm actually going to bump up my oranges just a hair and blues. Just kind of adjusting the picture as I'm going along here. So I'm actually going to take the blue down to about a negative 35. And as I'm going along to each bar here, I'm looking at the photograph and just kind of getting a feel for good colors here. So now let's go ahead and scroll down to sharpening. I want to sharpen this building up and make this picture pop a lot more. So what I'm going to do is take sharpening up to about 51. I'm going to hold my option key down on Mac, which is your alt key on PC, and I'm going to click and bring that to the right, and I'm going to sharpen everything that's white is getting sharpened right here. which makes it pop a little bit more. Now there's definitely a little bit of noise in this photograph, so I'm gonna go ahead and bring this up to about 45. Want to be careful not to go too much, because all of a sudden your photograph's gonna look really pasty looking. Under lens correction tab here, I'm gonna click enable profile correction. So as you can see, as I click on and off it, it's actually making the picture a lot more flat. And if it doesn't work on yours, you can always just click under lens profile, click once, and then just pick whatever lens you were using on that particular night. Under transform tab here, if you just click down, we're gonna go to auto. So what I'm doing here, since I was using a wide angle lens, it kind of gives it a real fisheye look, and the poles are kind of leaning to the back. By clicking auto, it made everything nice and straight. So kind of go back and forth there. Now under the effects tab, just come down to dehaze, and I'm gonna crank this up to probably about 5. Now I do have a little bit of lens flare going on in this cloud here. So I'm gonna get the spot removal tool here and see if I could try to fix this a little bit. So I'm gonna click once, gonna feather out just a little bit. And it matched it up really nice, so it kind of helps blend in the clouds a little more. Okay, now what I want to do is really touch up these buildings and the trees here, and I'm going to light some of this stuff up. So I always love to use the radial filter here, so I'm going to click on that. I'm going to temporarily hold my option key down, which is your alt key on your PC. So as you can see, every time I hold it down, it'll take what says effect, and it'll turn it to reset. Let me click once. Basically, I'm resetting all these tabs here. Now what I want to do is take the exposure up to about 32, and I'm going to click and create a little circle here on the building. Then I'll come over here, just the exposure just a little bit. I'll do another one right here. And the idea is I'm trying to make this building pop a little bit to where it draws the attention towards it. And I think I'll add a little one right here in the snow in front. I can always rotate. Maybe put another one right here. I'm just going nice and gentle. I just don't want this to be too overwhelming, but it sometimes just takes a little bit of playing around. And then another trick I like to do, I'll take a nice big one. I'm taking this circle on top of all these other ones. And I'm gonna bump the clarity up just a little bit more here. And I'm gonna take my saturation up a little bit to probably about 13. I'll take it down a little bit. Let's go about 3 on that one, just to make it pop just a hair more. And then I'm gonna go ahead and hit done. So once again, let's look at the before and after. As you can see, I really took a dull, boring looking photograph and really made it pop here. So anyways, that's some tips and tricks on how to retouch that photograph. This helped you out. Definitely hit the like button down below. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and share this video with anybody you think that could help them out. And we'll catch you on the next video. You have yourself a really good one.